This video was produced in the framework of the CLIMED-FRUIT project and will allow you to discover one operational group involved in the project and the different results and testimonies that resulted from it. Starting, a little tutorial to remind you how to put YouTube subtitles in your language. First, click on the Settings button. Then on the Subtitles button. You can click on the auto-generated proposal. Once it is done, click again on the Subtitles button. Let's start with the general presentation of this operational group.
The context and the issues that were related with the project was drought. As you know, we have this problem in Spain, not specifically in the Valencian community right now, but it's getting higher because we have less rain and less water. So we have to use high energetic costs to irrigate our crops, and this is really bad for us. And the agroecological transitions, because we are changing the crop to adapt it to a less phytosanitary using processes, and everything in the European Union is going towards this way. And also we want to mitigate climate change in the crop. For that, we use precision agriculture to know if we are over or under fertilization, and reduce costs and also products. Irrigation and fertilization in a more efficient way. And as I mentioned, the high energetic costs were going really hard for farmers. So this agriculture makes more efficient, and we spend less money on the irrigation system. For that, we did the operative group Go CITRICS project. It was funded by the Ministry of Agriculture of Spain, and it brings together irrigation communities, citrus growers, researchers, and advisors. The years of implementations were from 2019 to 2021. And here is the webpage. I already sent you with some information of the project, and you can check there different information related to it. The objectives and or the main goals of the project was to develop a precision citriculture through the implementation of efficient water and fertilization management, improving quality and production of citrus. We use Capacitance probes, satellite information. This one we didn't use in the other project, but this was a good idea to combine it with drone flights, because it can be cheaper, and also you can combine the information and get more inputs. We adopt the use of a citrus management platform based on this information with some companies that were involved in the project. And finally, we transfer it to the sector through different meetings. It was mainly online because it was during the pandemic. And we collect people from different sectors, farmers, irrigation communities, to apply all these tools on the crops. The partners involved in the project were our association, the Association of the Valencian Farmers Association, and also the one that we have in Malaga. We had three research centers involved in the project. They are public. One is from here, from the Valencian community, and the other ones were located in the Andalusia part. We also had contact with technology companies that were involved in the project for the drone technologies, and also for the capacitance probes. The geographical area of application was in the Mediterranean area of Spain, Valencia and Castellón, and in Andalusia in Málaga. First, we did a training meetings with the irrigation communities to see the problems they had with the irrigation systems, to detect when they were using more water, and to see what solutions we could give them. The different technologies that we, as I mentioned, the different technologies that we used were the probes, the drone flights, satellite information, and the blogs. We did different social innovation meetings with people from different sectors, the environmental sector, the social sector, and also the farmers and the economical sector. Finally, we disseminated all the results through material, written material that we will explain later.
Now that you know more, let's see the results that came out of this project.
The selected practice solutions that we are going to present to you related with this project were the capacitance probes, ground sensors that indicate the amount of water available in the soil, through an application called Irrimax Live from the company Centec, the drone and satellite images, a data collection through multi-spectral cameras and satellite information about irrigation for decision making using infrared arrays. For that, the application was called LIARPS. And the third one is the one that we introduced with the questions, the mulching. We used a rice straw from the Albufera Natural Park of Valencia, which is a byproduct difficult to manage. And currently is being burned, so it was better to give it another option at the citrus farms to reduce the evaporation of water from the soil. We are going to put now a video to explain the first practices, the capacitance probes, the drone flight, and the satellite information with our agronomist and farmer Alejandro Melia.
El proyecto GoCITRICS es un proyecto realizado en España, en la Comunidad Valenciana y en Andalucía, concretamente en la provincia de Málaga, donde se buscaban establecer prácticas agronómicas en pro de reducir el uso del agua y optimizar el rendimiento de las plantas mediante el uso de sensores de suelo, mediante vuelos aéreos con drones y con la implementación de técnicas agronómicas que permitían reducir el uso del agua. Uno de los puntos del proyecto GoCITRICS fue la instalación de sondas de capacitancia que permitían medir la humedad del suelo. Junto con la plataforma Irrimax nos permitió establecer los umbrales de riego, tanto los umbrales máximos como mínimos en los cuales debíamos de reponer nuestro riego, lo que nos permitió hacer un uso más eficiente de nuestra agua. Otra de las acciones que realizamos dentro del proyecto GoCITRICS fue la implementación de un mulch proveniente de la paja de arroz, que es un subproducto del cultivo del arroz que se realiza en nuestra zona de proximidad de la Albufera de Valencia. La paja del arroz es un producto que nos genera una difícil gestión, ya que estamos en un entorno natural y para su eliminación tradicionalmente se ha usado la quema de esta paja, con la consiguiente emisión de gases invernaderos que producía la atmósfera. Por ello, con la recuperación de esta paja de arroz y la implementación en nuestros cultivos, buscamos por una parte solucionar el problema que nos generaba los residuos de este subproducto y por otra intentar reducir el uso del agua en nuestros campos de cítricos. Con el mulch de paja de arroz conseguimos reducir la evaporación de nuestro terreno y por tanto podemos reducir los aportes de agua que realizamos en nuestro cultivo de cítricos. Para ello instalamos dentro de la misma parcela dos sondas, una en la zona donde teníamos mulching y otra en la zona sin mulching, para poder sacar conclusiones y ver qué porcentaje real de agua estábamos ahorrando con la utilización de esta técnica. Esta experiencia vimos que conseguíamos reducir en torno al 15% de nuestro aporte de agua en la zona donde introdujimos el mulch con respecto a la zona donde no se introdujo, que teníamos el suelo descubierto. Con el uso de la paja de arroz como mulch, por una parte conseguimos mitigar el problema que supone su quema en un parque natural como es el de la Albufera de Valencia, y por otra parte estamos reduciendo el consumo de agua de nuestro cultivo y estamos proveyendo a nuestro suelo de materia orgánica que nos ayudará también a mejorar la estructura del suelo. Otra técnica que utilizamos dentro del proyecto GoCITRICS para reducir el uso de agua en los cítricos fue la realización de vuelos de dron, para, mediante el uso de cámaras multiespectrales, poder medir qué cantidad de humedad tenía nuestro cultivo y así poder dar recomendaciones de riego dirigidas. Con los vuelos de dron también utilizamos imágenes satelitales proporcionadas por el satélite Sentinel, las cuales también nos ayudaban a ajustar más las recomendaciones que podíamos dar mediante el uso del vuelo de dron. Hay que tener en cuenta que los vuelos de drones los realizábamos cada 15-20 días, mientras que las imágenes satelitales las obteníamos cada 4-5 días. también la consideración mayor es que el vuelo de dron nos permite tener mayor detalle sobre nuestro cultivo que una imagen satelital, ya que la resolución es mucho mejor utilizando el vuelo de dron. Fruto de este programa operativo GoCITRICS, se redactaron dos manuales enfocados al mantenimiento y revisión de las instalaciones de riego por goteo, tanto para comunidades de regantes como para parcelas propias. Además, también se redactó otro manual enfocado en técnicas para la agricultura de precisión en la citricultura española. Estos manuales pueden ser de aplicación en todos los países donde se cultiven cítricos dentro del arco mediterráneo.
So as Alejandro was mentioning, the capacitance probes we checked because the ground probes that are buried in the soil and allow us to know the amount of water at different depths. With citrus rods, an average reach a depth of 50 centimeters. So if we detect water at 75 centimeters, it means there is water that citrus are not using. And if we do not detect sufficient water at 50 centimeters, the trees may be suffering from water stress. So these capacitance probes in the plots that were installed were allowing us to correct those mistakes that we were making on our irrigation and make it more efficient. For that, the application that we use is the Irrimax Light. This application coordinates with the capacitance probes, allows the irrigation efficiency, and if there is any problem, we detect if there is any problem in the plot. The graphs show the water content in the area of action of the probe, and therefore it allows to determine the optimal moment to irrigate the field. Here you can see an example of one of the plots that we checked. Xavi could explain a little bit about the graph situation in the soil.
As you can see, on summer months, we can see the low state of water in soil, and it coincides with the upper graphics, so was the irrigation on every moment, and we can irrigate at moments of we have the lower level of water, and we can provide the exact amount of water that we need in every moment. And combining the information of satellites and drones and the information of the capacitance probes, we can, with the program Irrimax Live, we can know the state of soil and the crop. Mm-hmm. In order to provide the water that the crops need in every moment. And as we can see on the red circle, we have a moment without information. That is because we lost the connection with the network of the capacity improves, and we lost.
So the other practice was drone and satellite images. With this data collection technology, and after processing the images provided by both the drone and the satellite, we can know the nutritional status of the plants, as well as the water status of the farm, knowing the areas with excess or deficit irrigation, which helps us to make the appropriate decision in each case. The difference between the drone images and the satellite images that Alejandro was mentioning also in the video is the ability of detail. Since the drone provides a resolution of 8 centimeters and the satellite just 20 meters. So it is you can have with the drone more information related with each tree than the information with the satellite, that it's more general and you don't know exactly what is the situation of one tree. On large farms, satellite information works very well, while on smaller farms, more detail is required. And that is the situation in the Valencian community, where we have small holdings, and it is better to have more precise information. In both cases, it is important to do a previous job of classifying the crops, variety, age, type of irrigation, characteristics of the soil, and we introduce that on the program to have all the data combined and see the best solutions. Here you see an image of the satellite information and the comparison with the drone flights, which is more detailed. And you can see the trees and different colors that indicate the status of the water, the irrigation. And yeah, here, another image where you can see the satellite information, it is not as precise. Also, the drone flights allow us with a line, a person, to see how it is in changing after the irrigation changes. The application layers, despite the fact that drone flights give us 3-to-3 information for economical reasons, we carried out with the frequency of satellite information images every 4 or 5 days. So that was convenient. And with the layers app, we can anticipate additional decision before the trees show obvious sign of deficiencies, know the water status and the irrigation efficiency, and identify very quick if there is an area of the plot with excess of deficit or deficit irrigation. That the thing is that in some locations, special permits are required to carry out drone flights at least 1 week in advance, and that makes it a little bit difficult. And as we mentioned, also expensive because you have to book an agronomist with knowledge about it, and it is sometimes it is better to combine them so you get information in a cheaper way. We are going to see now another video with another practice, the rice straw mulching, and later we will comment it.
Otra de las acciones que realizamos dentro del proyecto Go Citrics fue la implementación de un mulch proveniente de la paja de arroz, que es un subproducto del cultivo del arroz que se realiza en nuestra zona de proximidad de la Albufera de Valencia. La paja del arroz es un producto que nos genera una difícil gestión, ya que estamos en un entorno natural y para su eliminación tradicionalmente se ha usado la quema de esta paja, con la consiguiente emisión de gases invernaderos que producía la atmósfera. Por ello, con la recuperación de esta paja de arroz y la implementación en nuestros cultivos, buscamos por una parte solucionar el problema que nos generaba los residuos de este subproducto y por otra intentar reducir el uso del agua en nuestros campos de cítricos. Con el mulch de paja de arroz conseguimos reducir la evaporación de nuestro terreno y por tanto podemos reducir los aportes de agua que realizamos en nuestro cultivo de cítricos. Para ello instalamos dentro de la misma parcela dos sondas, una en la zona donde teníamos mulching y otra en la zona sin mulching, para poder sacar conclusiones y ver qué porcentaje real de agua estábamos ahorrando con la utilización de esta técnica. En esta experiencia vimos que conseguíamos reducir en torno al 15% de nuestro aporte de agua en la zona donde introdujimos el mulch con respecto a la zona donde nos introdujo, que teníamos el suelo descubierto. Con el uso de la paja de arroz como mulch, por una parte conseguimos mitigar el problema que supone su quema en un parque natural como es el de la Albufera de Valencia, y por otra parte estamos reduciendo el consumo de agua de nuestro cultivo y estamos proveyendo a nuestro suelo de materia orgánica que nos ayudará también a mejorar la estructura del suelo. Fruto de este programa operativo Go Citrics se redactaron dos manuales enfocados al mantenimiento y revisión de las instalaciones de riego por goteo, tanto para comunidades de regantes como para parcelas propias. Además, también se redactó otro manual enfocado en técnicas para la agricultura de precisión en la citricultura española. Estos manuales pueden ser de aplicación en todos los países donde se cultiven cítricos dentro del arco mediterráneo.
This mulch helps to reduce evaporation of water from the soil. We checked with the probes and it was a 15% of reduction of water from the plot that we applied it. And it creates a barrier between the soil and the air, which helps maintain soil moisture or humidity. And also in the composition process of this mulching layer, we provide the exploitation with organic matter that increase the porosity of the soil, which allows water to filter more easy towards the roots of the plants. And also we don't have competition because it is not a live cover. And also it provides with microorganisms and earthworms that are beneficial to the crop, and we are encouraged with this mulch. As a result of this project, we wrote two manuals, one on precision agriculture in irrigation and fertilization, because citrus is a very traditional crop in our area, and a great irrigation is necessary to improve its profitability. And this manual aims to show the different options for sensorization and automation of irrigation and fertilization to increase the efficiency of the plot. The other manual was of maintenance of irrigation communities and plot installation. As we were mentioning, small holdings are the characteristic of the Valencian city culture, and to increase irrigation efficiency from the beginning of the crop, irrigation communities were created to manage the wells. So they coordinate different areas of plots, and they irrigate together, and they can check with one prop, for instance, if they have the same soil, they can check if they are doing it properly and change whatever they need to change to make it more efficient. And the objective of this manual is to summarize the maintenance of the irrigation installations of these communities, as well as those of the individual farmer.